New York City. This is Moneyline with Lou Dobbs.
Today in Tokyo, more resistance to Boone Pickens' investment in Koito Manufacturing. The president of the Japanese firm refusing Pickens' seats on the board of that company and demanding that Pickens answer some questions about his purchase of 20% of the stock of the company. Just last week, Pickens made the trip to Tokyo to do just that. But since the very beginning, that sale has been subject to allegations of green mail and an investigation by the Japanese government. In the relatively closed financial markets of Japan, only 4% of listed stocks are owned by foreign investors. Pickens' entry into the market 3 weeks ago is so unique that it's been compared to the day that Commodore Perry sailed into Tokyo Bay back in 1863. Well, joining me now to talk about his controversial investment is Boone Pickens, the president, chairman of Mesa Petroleum, and the head of Boone Co. Boone, good to have you with us here tonight.
Lou, glad to be here.
Now, you say you just wanted to be an active investor, a long-term investor in Koito, and look what happened. Did you anticipate any of this?
Lou, I really didn't anticipate it. We came out early on and said this is not a takeover attempt. It's not hostile. We want to be a long-term investor, and we were very sincere about that. And the attitude has been somewhat different than we expected from the management. And it's interesting today. They're calling on us to give details as to the purchase of the block and all. And this is from the management of the company. Now, the stock's already been transferred to us. We're stockholders. We're owners. It's most unusual attitude by management. I can't imagine how I would. Approach one of our stockholders and tell him I want to know who they bought it from, what they paid for it, and how they're going to pay for it or finance it or whatever else. So,
well, of course, that's one thing about doing business in the United States. Quite another to do business, as you know and as you are learning, doing business in Japan or, for that matter, any other part of the world. You've been accused of green mail. You bought the
Yeah, but you know I've testified. 10 times before Congress, I'm against green mail. I've been offered green mail probably more than any other person in the world, and I've turned it down every time it's been offered. We told them we had no interest in green mail. But, Lou, this is not a two-way street, I found out. You know, I've made these speeches, and you've heard some of my remarks about a global economy and that free markets, open market, open access and all. But we've got a trade imbalance here with the Japanese of $55 billion, and I can tell you it's not going to be solved the way things are going. Now, you know, Japan is the second largest economy in the world, and they are opting out of allowing goods and services to come into their country when they quickly go all over the world to sell their goods.
Well, Boone, you have said that you won't say how much you've got invested. You won't disclose the price or the structure of the deal, but as I understand it, you did buy those shares from the Japanese businessman Watanabe. Is
that's
that correct?
Correct. That is correct.
And there are reports that he, in fact, attempted green mail of a sort, trying to sell those shares to Toyota. Is there any truth in your judgment to that view of the matter?
I can't speak to it specifically. I've heard the same stories, but I think that was over a year ago. And we bought the block off of, I met Mr. Watanabe in November, and we bought the block in March, and it was transferred to us, and we will be allowed to vote at the stockholders meeting June 29th at Koito's stockholders meeting.
Well, at this point, running into the problems you have, irrespective of what the firm does request of you, you own the stock. You are a legitimate owner, as I understand, 20% of the outstanding shares. Management's reaction to you won't change that, will it?
No, we've been around a long time. We've had experience with managements before in companies where we were large stockholders, and we are their largest stockholder. But it's really intriguing to me that, you know, this is my first introduction to a Japanese deal. And I can tell you that's a closed system over there. They do not want us in their financial markets. And we're sitting here with a big trade deficit that someplace the Japanese are going to have to open up to us.
Have you talked to some of your fellow investors, for example, the principals of Toyota, about their reaction? Did you discuss your investment at any point with them?
Well, Toyota is the second largest stockholder in Koito Manufacturing, and they own 19%. No, we have not talked to Toyota.
Do you sense any
objection? But also remember, Lou, that the that about 50% of Kiwito's business is with Toyota. They do the lighting on the Toyota cars, and a Toyota man is the CEO of Kiwito. So well, it's a pretty close tie there.
Well, that's the reason I asked the question, Boone, thinking that you would be aware of those ties, that you might have looked to have some sort of discussion either initially or subsequently with Toyota. You have no interest whatsoever in selling your shares. Would that change if you're denied seats on the board?
Well, let's let it run out a little bit further, because I don't like to start answering hypothetical situations, but we Toyota has three members on the board, and they have 19% of the stock, and we have 20%, and we ask for the same representation on the board that Toyota had, and we were turned down.
Have you talked with the Japanese government, the Ministry of Industry and Trade there?
Yes, we have. We actually, you know, we had to clear this through the Minister of Finance on the transfer of stock from Watanabe to Bunko, and that was done fully. They knew exactly what we were doing, and we were asking for help in making that transfer.
Has any help been forthcoming in terms of working out seats on the board of Koito?
No,
from the government, the Japanese government.
No, I don't think Japanese government. I don't see them getting involved in that. But it's really interesting, Lou. I've gotten probably 50 telephone calls and letters on this very subject, and I can tell you there is a grassroots feeling in America that the Japanese are taking us over, and that we are not getting the same access to their markets.
Well, moving from the grassroots to something a little closer to home, or at least a little closer to where you are, Washington, I know you talked with Carla Hills and Commerce Secretary Mosbacher today. Did you seek their assistance in resolving your problems?
What I wanted to do, no, I didn't ask. I did not ask for help, and I just told them I wanted to, witnessed some things here, and I felt like I wanted to share it with them and talked at length with both Ambassador Hills and also with Secretary Mosbacher. But I was not asking them to do anything. But we also met with a number of congressmen and senators on the Hill that are involved in trade matters. And so that has that was interesting, because I can tell you they are up to speed on this subject.
Okay. Boone, we appreciate you taking the time to join us, and as you say, we'll just watch how this thing unfolds.
Good.
Boone Pickens.
Thanks, Lou. Okay.
Thank you.